How you doing, guys? It's Alessandro here from Spicy Moustache with some new tips in order to help you create in your own green area, indoor or outdoor, following the principle of do as nature does. Today is one of the hottest days of the year, so we hope in a good change in the garden. However, not all the areas of your garden are fully exposed to sunlight, but there are a few areas that could be in full or partial shade. Beginner gardeners, especially in an urban environment like mine, with many buildings surrounding your garden, could be easily get confused or misled about what to plant in a shady area of your garden. So dig up the like button, and today I'll show you over 10 different crops that produce food in a shady area of your garden. There are many different informations online about what to plant where in your garden to grow your own food. I get people all the time asking me what to plant in an area with shade, especially in a city where most gardens are surrounded by houses. However, you need to keep in mind that there is lots of potential to grow food in shady areas of your garden. Even if the harvest won't be as high, you will still produce food. So don't be scared about experimenting and trying to plant things that are not supposed to be grown in shade. You might actually get surprised about what can be harvested in a shady area. The most common vegetables that could be grown in an area with partial or full shade in your garden are leafy brassicas. This might include kale or pak choy. If you start on a garden or you're just approaching the new season, plan ahead and plant leafy brassicas in any shaded area of your garden. One of the main reasons is to avoid flowering, or more commonly known as bolting, which happens when the temperature are raising up. The second reason is that they prefer to thrive in a shaded area, and a little shade could actually be an advantage. Also, sheltering your plants from the sun means that you will have to water less often. This is my rainbow chard. It grows in red, green, and yellow, and other than great in the kitchen, it's a perfect display in your garden. Chard is a really cold tolerant, and you can continuously harvest leaves, and the plant will simply produce more. I personally think that it's an extremely low-care plant, and I usually sow it indoor and move outdoor 2-3 weeks after the last wave of frost is gone. An interesting fact is that Swiss chard and beets belong to the same family. A shared characteristic of both beets and rainbow Swiss chard, it's a really visible one. They both contain a compound called betalain. Betalain are nitrogen-containing water-soluble compounds that are found only in a limited number of plants. To the naked eye, they are simply pigments of red and yellow. Spinach are great plants that tolerate an almost fully shaded area, really easy to grow and very productive. The leaves could be used fresh, but also as the plant is so productive, there are many ways of preserving, freezing, or dehydrating for later use. It's a really cool tolerant plant, and it doesn't thrive great in full sun, which makes it a great candidate for your shady garden. What it means is that usually, after 2-3 weeks since I planted some, I sow some more directly in the area where I want to grow it. So in this way, I can harvest it in waves. If you don't have any shaded area in your garden, you can simply plant it under a tall plant. So in this way, you will have that nice shade necessary for the plant to thrive. The next perfect plant for your shady garden will be almost any kind of leafy lettuce. From a gardener point of view, this is one of the most refreshing vegetables for the hot summer days. Leafy lettuce thrives great in partial shade, and if left in full sun, they tend to flower, or commonly called bolting. Bolting happens when a plant is stressed, especially from a temperature change, and goes into flower and seed. After a leafy vegetable bolts, it stops producing those nice big leaves that you're growing it for. Any further leaves produced by the plant will also have a really bitter flavor that you will not want to consume them. Lettuce is a great companion plant for spring onions, or it could be planted in the middle of your A-frames for peas and beans. Peas are a spring crop that suffer damages when exposed to the full sun of summer days. However, they are at the peak of their production between the end of spring and the beginning of summer. This means that you could potentially plant them in partial shade, and you will still have a great harvest because they are protected from direct sunlight. You could also potentially plant them for the shoots, which gives you first of all another way to consume them, and second, a really early crop that could be harvested over and over. Just remember to soak them overnight in water and plant them ideally straight into your garden. They don't really like to be moved around. However, indoor sowing, it's absolutely possible, You just need to be more careful whenever you are transplanting them out. I love to grow peas because they take up a minimal space, and also thanks to their vertical growth, you can plant them along a fence or a wall. Another group of plants that thrives absolutely great in partial shade or full shade are herbs. As you can see here, I've got many different herbs growing in this raised bed, including chives, rosemary, oregano, thyme, and a few more. This is our front yard that we recently converted into a community garden for the neighbors, and it's exposed to sunlight only late in the afternoon. Herbs that don't like their soil to dry out in the summer tend to do well in shade. I also make sure to mulch with wood chips or starch mulch, which retains moisture and keep the root mass cool down even on the hot summery day. You can grow most herbs in partial shade, but some will do less well because they are really sun loving. If grown in partial shade, the Mediterranean herbs will need extra drainage, and this is why when I prepare the soil mix, I add extra perlite to make sure they have that nice drainage. The next shade-loving plant that I plant in my garden is rhubarb. And you should plant this out in spring as soon as the soil is workable. You can plant this from seed, even if it's gonna take a long time to germinate and grow. Or the quicker way is to plant it in crown, well spaced, because it could potentially grow to 4 feet tall and wide. Rhubarb is also an excellent companion plant for onions and many brassicas, and it could be planted in full sun or partial shade. The plant needs to be kept moist but not soaking wet. In fact, drainage is an essential part of growing rhubarb, or it will rot and die. The general rule of thumb is to not eat rhubarb from July onwards. Allowing the plant to grow for the rest of the summer without harvesting, it will give it the necessary sugars and nutrients to pull through the winter and come back in the next season stronger and more productive. If the plant is kept in the right conditions, you will have a great rhubarb production over many years. Another shady vegetable that is well underestimated and not grown enough is radish. I'm planting two varieties today, called Chinese large radish and Spanish black radish. Most varieties could be sown throughout the year as they are really easy and quick to grow. They thrive best in shade, and direct exposure to sunlight will slow down their growth. You can direct sow them in ground at 1 inch deep and 1 inch apart, depending on the variety that you're growing, because for example, daikon grows really large. It is a really refreshing vegetable due to the high content of water. Also, one of my favorite things to eat is noodles, and adding fresh radish to a dish of noodles is just the perfect match. I just harvested a big batch of potatoes from this container, so I don't have it in the garden right now. However, this is another great crop to grow in a shady area of your garden. I recommend to grow them in container because you will be surprised by the amount of potatoes you can harvest, and you can also move them around your garden to protect it from the sunny days during the summer. It doesn't matter if you're growing first, early, second, early or main crop, they all thrive great in partial or almost full shade. Another great way to grow them is to use your compost bin, so you can save space in your garden. Another great use for a shady area of your garden would be to keep your compost bin. I keep mine along the fence, so it never really gets direct sunlight, except for midday. This is really important because heat could be an issue when producing your compost. The evaporation rate of the moisture on your compost pile will decrease really quick on a sunny day during the summer. If kept in the shade, you will have a better water retention, and also you will have to water less. I also keep my water tank on side of my compost bin along the fence because the whole area is shaded. This is great to keep your rainwater collection or any other tank of water protected from the sunlight at cool temperature and maintain the quality of the water. Following the retailer recommendation about where to plant and when to plant in your garden, it's always good to give ideal thriving condition to your plant. However, as I mentioned before, try your own experiment and plant plants in different parts of your garden, even if they're not supposed to stay in shade or full sun. It will teach you a lot not only about the plant, but also how to use the space and maximize the harvest in your growing area. I hope you liked today's video, and if so, please subscribe to my channel, turn on the notification setting so you can be notified every time I post a new video. And I'll see you next Friday for a new episode. Thank you so much for watching. See ya.